statements made during this broadcast regarding products or the claims made about specific products have not been evaluated by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. Products and treatments discussed are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent disease. Make your physician aware of all nutritional supplements used and immediately notify your physician if you have any health concern or undiagnosed sign or symptom. Let's Talk Nutrition is a health talk show that features scientists, authors, nutrition specialists, personal trainers, holistic healers, and experts in traditional, natural, and integrative medicine. Listen for a chance to win daily prizes and follow Let's Talk Nutrition on Facebook and Instagram at Let's Talk Nutrition or on Twitter at LTN Radio. It's time for some inspiration. Tune in to get fit and healthy. It's time to talk about nutrition. Nutrition for your body, your mind, your spirit. It's time to talk about proper exercise, stress relief, eating well, and supplementation to help. Get ready to take charge of your health because your health is your wealth and the wealth of those who care about and love you. It's time for Let's Talk Nutrition with Dr. Michael Garko. Welcome to the show.
Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Thanks for tuning in today. Glad you could stop by, and I'm glad to be here with you. Dr. Aimee Shunney, right, Josh, will be my guest today. I like Dr. Shunney a whole lot. She's a naturopathic physician and has her practice in California. Of course, we have guests on this show from all over the place, within the continental United States and in other from other countries as well. She's pretty exceptional, very bright, and knows what she's doing. So we'll talk with her today. She hasn't been on for a while. I always enjoy my conversations with her. I met her a few years ago at I was visiting Nordic Naturals office and facilities in California, and I had to attend a meeting, and she was in the meeting. That's where I met her. I was impressed with her then. And she doesn't disappoint. I find her to be so natural and authentic, you know. She doesn't give you the politically correct answer. She gives you the answer as she understands it to be and doesn't try to finesse it. I like that. I'm sure you do too, right? In this day and age. I live here in Tampa, Florida, and this is where the show originates. And I mention this, of course, being in Florida, if you're following the news, let me hand this to my one producer so he can find this. I'll need that back in a second. If you're following the news, in Miami, they have a Zika virus problem. It's in one particular, one square mile. It's a very trendy area of Miami. I used to live in Miami, and that's a very trendy area of Miami. And health officials are trying to contain it. I was talking with one of my colleagues here at the station yesterday. This is the first time I've talked about it and reported on it on the show. I refrained from doing it because I didn't want to. You have that? Can I have it back? Thanks. I'm talking to Josh. I'm not talking to although I do talk to myself. I'm talking with one of my producers. And I thought maybe I could share with you some insight into this virus. And I know we're here in Tampa, and we're, you know, quite a ways from Miami, and they're saying that even place down on Miami Beach, you don't have to worry because you got the ocean breeze and the mosquitoes don't tend to go there. The wind keeps them away and this and that. But I'm sure people in Miami are nervous. And my thinking is if it got to Miami, well, you know what? Mosquitoes don't obey borders. So I thought, let's talk about it a little bit. I'll be reporting from different sources. And there's a lot of information on it. And this one one article I found, there's several, talks about where the Zika virus originated and why it's a particular problem in Brazil. So I'll start there and we'll see where it takes us. And I have Stevens checking the pronunciation. Come on here with me, Steven, if you would. There, the Zika virus has, I can tell you the Zika virus was first detected in Zika forest. There's a forest called Zika Forest, Z-I-K-A, in Uganda. That was in 1947. This virus was detected. And where did they find it? In rhesus monkey, in a rhesus monkey. And again, they found it in 1940, that was in 47. And then in 1948, the mosquito, is it Aedes africanus, which is the forest, relative of the, is it Aedes aegypti? Is that how you pronounce it?
I could not find it. I found the genus of it. It's a flaviviridae.
Yeah,
but I couldn't find the Latin term for it.
It's spelled A E D E S, and then the second is A E G Y P T I. That particular mosquito spread the Zika virus. You should also know that the virus can be sexually transmitted. Yeah.
Aedes aegypti or T.
Aedes aegypti? I was close. Aedes aegypti. That wasn't Stephen in a falsetto voice. That Although, I would have been impressed if you could get that high in your pitched voice. Aedes aegypti. That's how you pronounce, that's the Latin name for it. Zika virus, bad little critter. The Zika has a lot in common with other viruses, emergent viruses, and this it originated in West and Central Africa and Southeast Asia, but they have now obviously expanded their range and includes much of the tropics and subtropics globally. And the Zika virus, you know, is spread by the same species that mosquito. We even have some. Do we have some pictures of those mosquito? That mosquito, it's a mosquito. They report that until 2007, there were very few cases of Zika in humans. That was up until 2007. Then things changed, and an outbreak occurred in a place called Yap, Y-A-P. Island of Micronesia. I haven't been there, and I don't think there's a McDonald's there either. Wherever the hell that is, I have no clue. Yap Island in Micronesia. Infecting about 75% of the population. My God. 6 years later, the virus spread then to French Polynesia, along with outbreaks of a couple of other viruses. It's really, trying to track this and put it together is something. So how did it get here? How did it get to the Americas? They did some genetic analysis of the virus and revealed that the strain in Brazil, the one in Brazil, was most similar to the one that had been circulating in the Pacific, which I just alluded to. Brazil had been on alert, they said, for an introduction of a new virus following the 2014 FIFA World Cup because the event concentrated people from all over the world. People carry the virus. I mean, a mosquito can bite a human, and then the mosquito gets infected. However, no Pacific Island nation with Zika transmission had competed at that event, making it less likely to be the source. But there's another theory of how the virus got here. They say that it may have been introduced following, of all things, an international canoe event held in Rio de Janeiro in August of 2014, which hosted competitors from various Pacific islands. Yet another possible route of introduction into the Americas was overland from Chile. Since that country had, they said, detected a case of Zika disease in a returning traveler from Easter Island. Unbelievable. Talk about an interdependent world, right? Everything's interconnected. Mosquitoes in Yap Island have now they're dealing with it in Miami. Okay? That's the world we live in. That's the nature of the planet. Come back, I'll tell you more.
Are you waking up each day to the life you have to live or to the life you want to live? Better health shouldn't be left to chance. Smart choices to living longer and stronger include making Kyolic Aged Garlic Extract a part of your daily routine. For years, medical researchers have recommended adding Kyolic to the diet as a powerful tool to enhancing overall heart and immune health. Recent clinical studies at UCLA Medical Center using Kyolic suggest that garlic may slow plaque formation in the arteries and support healthy cholesterol and homocysteine levels. Previous research also shows Kyolic may enhance your immune system defenses. Kyolic is organic, odorless, and the only antioxidant garlic supplement available worldwide. Maintaining a healthier you could extend your life. Your wellness begins with Kyolic Aged Garlic Extract, available everywhere fine nutritional supplements are sold. Visit Kyolic.com, that's Kyolic.com, or call 1-800-421-2998 for a free sample today.
Still looking for your fountain of youth? It's Zinnia. Look no further than the beauty aisle of your favorite health and nutrition store. Zinnia is the newest product from Form Essentials, the brand that brought you Solace. So you know it's filled with the highest quality ingredients. Many cosmetic products only treat topically, while Zinnia addresses aging and hair loss from within. Formulated to support the growth of radiant hair, skin, and nails, Zinnia is sure to help you turn back the hands of time and assist you in aging gracefully. Zinnia provides a spectrum of key vitamins and other evidence-based natural ingredients such as alpha lipoic acid, biotin, and collagen and elastin peptides, all combined in one capsule for your convenience. By promoting beauty from the inside out, you're strengthening your cells and creating a lasting enhancement to your natural beauty. Zinnia fits into your daily routine and can be taken to boost your current cosmetic products. Available now at leading health and nutrition stores. Ask for Zinnia by name. Start taking Zinnia hair, skin, and nails today and get ready to look amazing.
At Country Life Vitamins, we've been helping people live happy, healthy lives since 1971, and we believe integrity should always be our number one ingredient. We are committed to this belief because you deserve high-quality nutrition, specifically crafted with the highest standards to support your health. Country Life's manufacturing facility is an NSF GMP-registered facility, as well as USDA-certified organic, so you can feel good about the products you're taking. Country Life Vitamins is also the first supplement company in the United States to have a complete line of products certified gluten-free. That's over 500 products. Country Life Vitamins' pledge of integrity is based on five standards: authenticity, cleanliness, freshness, consistency, and accuracy. Ask for Country Life's top-selling products, such as Coenzyme B Advanced for increased energy or Flexable for joint health. Country Life Vitamins' commitment to ensure all of our products are pure, wholesome, gluten-free supplements full of natural goodness provides peace of mind with the knowledge you are using a brand you can trust.
Did you know that when it comes to supporting whole body health, there's an herbal supplement that may be as important as your daily multivitamin? Discover Zyflamend Whole Body from New Chapter, formulated to support a whole body healthy inflammation response, an ongoing natural process and part of the body doing its job. We often think of the inflammation response as something we can feel, such as where there are sensitive nerve endings. But did you know that we can also have an inflammation response we can't feel? And whether we are aware of it or not, our inflammation response can affect the whole body. Zyflamend is a patented blend of 10 remarkable herbs, including pure and potent turmeric, that help balance and support your body's natural, healthy inflammation response for overall health and wellness. And it's clinically tested. Discover the premier herbal supplement for whole body health from New Chapter, Zyflamend Whole Body. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease. Available at your local fine health food store.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by BSN, Finish First, Nordic Naturals, Pure and Great Tasting Omega Oils, Jaro Formulas, Superior Nutrition and Formulation, Natural Factors, Where Great Health Begins, Kyolic, Aging Makes the Finest Garlic Truly Odorless, A. Vogel, Europe's Leading Brand of Herbal Medicine. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome back. Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. Reporting a little bit on this Zika virus. It's the first time I've reported on this particular issue. I live in Tampa, and of course this virus now has made its way into Miami, in this a high-end, trendy area of Miami. It's a 1 square mile, but has health officials pretty nervous, as well as the people living in Miami. They're telling them, oh, if you live near the beach, no, don't worry, you're near the Y. Yeah, right. I'm in Tampa, and I'm a little anxious about it. But what's curious is, of course, the vector is the mosquito, right? Humans as well carry the virus. But you might wonder, I came across an interesting article by Alexandra Sifferlin in Time. She wrote about why people get so many diseases from mosquitoes. And the Zika virus is the latest mosquito-borne virus to now come into the United States and infect people and have serious health consequences for pregnant women. I mean, serious. The poor babies and mother, the baby's once born with encephaly and such brain damage, and it's just horrible. You got mosquitoes carry malaria, dengue, fever, West Nile virus. Mosquitoes are quite small, right? And you say, okay, they have, as pointed out in the article, these sort of vampire-like tendencies, and they literally drink the blood, and it's the female, because she, in order for her to perpetuate the offspring, she needs to have blood. And so when she bites a human, she ingests the microbes directly. And if a human's infected, the mosquito will pick up the virus. These are microscopic, of course. And mosquitoes are mobile. They can move over distances. Their lifespan isn't very long, but they can even move a few miles. And little by little, they make their way, with the help of the environment and so on. And so they can have some trajectory in finding their blood meals and then spreading the disease in the process is what goes on. It is the female, she's responsible. She's trying to, it's survival, man. She's trying to provide nutrition for her eggs. So Dr. Janet McAllister, she says, some of these species have even developed a preference for feeding on humans over other animals, close quote. That's so intriguing. They can identify the target. They can separate a human from another animal. They know. Amazing. She said that mostly those that will bite humans have become very good at taking blood from us without noticing. Some prefer to bite at night when we're sleeping. They're so clever. Others, those that bite during the day, she said, or early evening, have chemicals in their saliva that allow them to bite without us noticing it right away. Because if they bite you and you notice it, you're going to swat at them and kill them. You see how nature is amazing. In other words, what has happened through natural selection, the mosquito has developed that ability to bite using chemicals so it goes undetected so you don't kill it. You can't make that up. That way they get their meal, they don't get killed, and you're infected if they have the virus. Thank you very much. Or they get infected if you have the virus, which can be, as I said earlier, transmitted through sexually, through intercourse. So humans become the mosquitoes get around and move around the planet. We become their chauffeur, in a word. And you can take them, people coming from, you know, these Pacific islands or wherever, the Yap Island in Micronesia, for heaven's sake. And in the article, they quote a doctor, Nikos Velisikas. He said, quote, a lot of these viruses are arbor viruses, and they are ancient viruses like the dengue and the Zika that have evolved alongside mosquitoes, these viruses. They have a common purpose here, survival, you know. The most prevalent vector is the domestic Aedes aegypti mosquito, which is the Zika, which carries the Zika virus, which originated in Africa but now has a global range, close quote. So there's this interesting relationship between among the virus, the mosquito, and humans. They said in this article that, and let me quote them, climate change is also at least partially responsible for where mosquitoes and the diseases they carry end up. Whereas in the past, the Aedes aegypti would not establish itself in more temperate regions, climate change would result in its northern or southern expansion. That change in range will also be accompanied by the introduction of these viruses in these territories, close quote. Again, we live on an interconnected planet. Everything's interconnected. We're connected to mosquitoes and viruses, and they're connected to us, and it's global. Be right back.
When your alarm goes off, do you jump out of bed with excitement? Or does it take multiple alarms, a few snooze buttons, or a morning caffeine fix to get you going? These habits and daily stress cause a vicious cycle in which sleep becomes increasingly elusive. In fact, 54% of Americans report struggles to fall or stay asleep. For a better night's rest, look no further than Solace, an all-natural dietary supplement that supports healthy sleep and relaxation so you get the rest you need to wake up clear-eyed, alert, and ready for the day. Solace has given thousands a better night's rest and the power to take back their mornings while enjoying the day ahead of them. Solace is formulated with non-addictive, scientifically proven, all-natural ingredients that support sleep and relaxation, such as melatonin, tryptophan, and 5-HTP. For more information or to order Solace, visit TakeSolace.com. Solace, for healthy sleep, naturally.
Looking for the perfect complement to your beauty regimen? Try Form Essentials Zinnia. The finest of its kind, Zinnia offers twice as much biotin as other formulas, which has proven to unlock the vibrancy in even the dullest of hair, skin, and nails. Zinnia breaks through and rejuvenates cells internally, helping you achieve the allure of effortless beauty. Reviving your hair, skin, and nails has never been easier. This essential blend of biotin, alpha lipoic, and hyaluronic acid, collagen, and vitamin C creates lasting enhancements to your natural good looks. Don't go on wondering, you're worth the results. This combination of ingredients can only be found in Zinnia. Pamper yourself with a proven bit of affordable luxury and start looking your best. Ask for Zinnia by name at your nearest vitamin retailer to begin your journey to restored nails, head-turning hair, and radiant skin today. For more information, visit formessentials.com.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by AlgaLife, algae for life. CV Sciences, from seed to shelf. New Chapter, the benefit of nature's wisdom. Yerba Prima, pioneers in internal cleansing. Form Essentials, makers of the sleep aid Solace. Now introducing Zinnia for healthy hair, skin, and nails. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome back. Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition, wherever and however you may be listening or watching the show, and whatever you may be doing. I've been reporting on this Zika virus and tried to share with you the origination of the virus and how it's connected to the mosquito Aedes aegypti, if one way, I guess, to pronounce it. And these different viruses, you know, the mosquito is a vector carrying these different viruses for malaria, chikungunya, and so on. So this interesting relationship between the virus and the mosquito, and then humans. And these mosquitoes, as I reported to you, certain species have developed an affinity for humans as a target. And it's the female who does the biting and then either gets infected or infects, because she's trying to feed her eggs. So here in the U.S., of course, Miami, that one square mile that I'm trying to think of the name of that. It's at the tip of my tongue. You think I can pull up out of my brain? It's in Miami. It's a very trendy area of Miami. Nice place. And they got their hands full there. We're in Tampa, but I have concerns. I'm thinking, well, you know, got to Miami. So I'm just saying. In the meanwhile, Dr. Aimee Shunney was my guest today. I'll talk more about this virus. The CDC has some statistics on the number of pregnant women who've been infected. It's just a horrible, horrible outcome for the once the child is born and for the mother. I mean, it's horrible. My God, it's heartbreaking. Heartbreaking. Remember when I said Yap Island? That was, they think that's where it all began. 75% of the population was infected. Can you imagine the number of children that have been affected by this? I can't imagine. At Yap Islands in Micronesia. This began in Micronesia. There's at least one area. Nevertheless, Dr. Aimee Shunney is an educator, and she for Nordic Naturals. She appears on my show from time to time, not often enough, however. That's my only complaint, and with that, I'll introduce her to you. Dr. Shunney, how are you?
I'm great. How are you? Good morning.
Doing fine.
What time is it there? Oh, it's still morning. Good morning. Yes.
Yeah, it's early for you. It's okay. Thank you for getting up. I'm sorry that you had to do that. I don't know. Have you followed this story much? This Zika virus business?
I mean, I've been following it peripherally, I think, like most people. I have not really delved particularly into it, and it's one of those things that I know I need to do. I mean, where I am, I mean, I have the quote-unquote privilege of being a little more isolated from it in regards to being concerned that I'm going to start seeing people walking in with it. I mean, it's been on my radar in so much as women trying to get pregnant, women traveling and things like that. But it feels like the slow motion avalanche that's been coming towards us, you know, because we've been told that this is going to happen, and yet it seems like everybody's just kind of been paralyzed and standing still watching this thing move towards us, and now it's here. I agree with you, it's quite frightening.
It is, and you know, I remember I lived in Miami, and if I were living there now, and even though it's isolated in that one square mile area, I lived close to the beach. So, but they say, you know, you're closer to the beach, the better, because of the winds and whatnot. It's But still, I would be very concerned and nervous. Generally speaking. But if a woman being pregnant, I mean, man.
That, yeah.
Encephaly, is it microencephaly? What is the exact, do you know the exact medical term that happened, the damage to the brain and what happens to the fetus?
Well, I believe that is the proper term, and it's a swelling. It's a swelling of the brain. I mean, it's just a terrible outcome. And you know, the question is, and now that there's that we're talking about sexual transmission as well.
Yeah, I mentioned that.
You know, that makes it feel very challenging to stop. You know, and then just what is the safety window? And, you know, again, these are areas where I really don't want to tout myself as an expert because I don't have the exact information that would be appropriate for me to call myself that. It is an outcome that the reason it's so terrible is because it's an outcome that we really don't have any kind of cure for. So
no cure.
We're talking about a baby that's born with an extremely debilitating brain injury, for lack of a better term, and that person is going to have that. So
yeah, it's micro meaning small encephaly. The brain, the head, the baby's head is smaller than would be expected in a normal childbirth. The brains are smaller with babies with microencephaly because they have not developed properly. The virus, it's interesting how that virus affects us in that way. I mean, I can't, you know, can you imagine the heartbreak of the moms and the dads and the parents? And my God.
No.
Can't even imagine. And the other day I was watching the news and they were in this clinic. I don't know if it was in Brazil or where it was. And it was a clinic to take care of the moms and the babies, the babies that were suffering from microencephaly. And I mean, I had I just stopped me dead in my tracks. I had just had to sit down for a second to look, and you see so many infants with that condition. You just breaks your heart. It just breaks your heart. I point I made, Dr. Shunney, was this planet is interconnected in such ways. I don't know if we really, sometimes we miss we don't appreciate how interconnected. Yap Island in Micronesia. Most people never heard of the Yap Island in Micronesia until I started doing the research. Is implicated in this. This all started back in 1947 when they found it in a rhesus monkey, the virus. And then they found it again in 1948. And, you know, mosquitoes, we become the carriers for the mosquitoes, right? We're carrying the virus, or we carry the virus. Unbelievable. I don't know. So, you doing okay?
More of.
We'll see how you're doing. I'll ask you when we come back.
At Nordic Naturals, we know that a commitment to deliver the world's safest, most effective omega oils requires an exceptional process. That's why we manage every step of production from boat to bottle. That includes sustainably sourcing wild-caught fish from well-managed fisheries. It means using state-of-the-art equipment and technology at our manufacturing plant in Arctic Norway. Nordic Naturals bottles and encapsulates our omega-3s at our own facility and carefully ships products from our eco-friendly headquarters in California. The result? Nordic Naturals products have received more than 40 awards for taste, innovation, and product excellence. You can trust the quality of Nordic Naturals products and know you're getting all the health benefits omega-3 fish oils offer. Nordic Naturals' high-quality, great-tasting omega-3s make staying healthy easier for you and your family. When choosing an omega-3 fish oil product, choose the number one fish oil in the U.S. Choose Nordic Naturals. Available at natural product retailers or online at nordicnaturals.com.
If you've ever had digestive issues slow you down, it's time to live digestively with the number one high-potency probiotic, Ultimate Flora. Because with 50 billion live cultures inside you, life feels a little lighter, a little livelier, a little more you. No matter where life takes you, live digestively with Ultimate Flora Probiotics from Renew Life. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease. Number one probiotic brand with 15 billion or more cultures based on annual sales. How can a sweet little fruit gummy help you live digestively? Ultimate Flora Probiotic Gummies put the ultimate natural digestive support to work inside you to help you feel a little lighter, a little more you. And if raspberry lemonade's a little more you, feel bubbly in a good way with Ultimate Flora Probiotic Fizzy Drink Mix. Ultimate Flora Probiotic Gummies and Fizzy Drink Mix, two great ways to live digestively, deliciously. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Everyone's raving about the newest botanical superstar hitting the store shelves nationwide. Hemp-derived cannabidiol, or CBD, has been receiving a lot of attention for its tremendous promise on human health. Plus, CBD oil by CV Sciences is the trusted brand setting the standards in this newly emerging category of plant-based extracts, offering a variety of hemp-derived CBD oil products that you can count on. In order to make the highest quality CBD oil products available, it is important to manage every step of the supply chain process, from seed to shelf. That's why, from harvesting our EU-certified hemp seeds, to laboratory testing for quality and safety, to producing our exceptional line of products, we are committed to going the extra mile. It is our commitment to you. Join the CBD evolution. Ask your local natural health retailer about Plus CBD oil products by CV Sciences today. Follow us on Facebook and learn more at pluscbdoil.com.
Exclusively from Natural Factors.
Hi, I'm Dr. Michael Murray. I'm very excited to have the opportunity to talk with you about PGX, a truly revolutionary natural product that works perfectly to help get at the core issues that make weight loss so difficult. PGX is a clinically proven way to help people to achieve their ideal body weight that is safe and natural. PGX leads to a dramatic reduction in the glycemic index of any food or meal. It also ultimately causes the release of compounds that achieve two important goals in weight loss. One, telling your brain that you're satisfied so you eat less, and two, improving the action of the hormone insulin. If you've ever tried to lose weight and failed, it's not your fault. You just need the tremendous support that PGX can provide. For more information on making your weight loss dream a near effortless reality, please go to pgx.com.
When you're passionate about your health, that passion leads to the knowledge that exercise and a healthy diet are not always enough. Sometimes you need the extra nutritional boost that only supplements can provide. If you are looking for the leading national brands of vitamins, supplements, health and beauty, weight loss or sports nutrition products, look no further than Vitamin Discount Center. Voted best independent chain by Vitamin Retailer Magazine. Vitamin Discount Center has been a trusted and valuable nutrition resource to the Tampa Bay area for over 15 years. With daily savings up to 50%, Vitamin Discount Center offers the best prices on the highest quality nutritional supplements. Not only will you find unbeatable value, your visit includes access to a staff educated on the application of products to help equip you with the products and information you need to proactively improve your health. To locate the store nearest you, visit vitamindiscountcenter.com, as well as access to articles on popular health topics, promotions, events, and thousands of products to shop from right at home. Your search for an affordable solution to better health is finally over. Vitamin Discount Center. For life, for less.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Now Foods, Our Products Work, American Biotech Labs, Your Daily Immune System Support, Renew Life, The Digestive Care Company, Country Life, a leader and authority in natural health and nutrition, Enzymedica, the enzyme experts, North American Urban Spice, the only oregano oil you can take on a daily basis. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Dr. Aimee Shunney's my guest today. Dr. Shunney is busy, you know. She has her practice, and she's on different medical boards, and she typically with Nordic Naturals when she comes onto the show. But today she's on representing CV Sciences. And we're always happy to have you on, Dr. Shunney. The last time you were on, I asked you if you were integrating this now trending dietary supplement, CBD oil, into your practice. Could you repeat what you said the last time I asked you that question? If you remember.
Yeah, right. Well, I don't know exactly what I said, but I do know the answer to the question. How are you, by the way?
I'm doing fine. I'm doing okay. We're one day at a time around here. We're taking it one day.
Is it really hot? Is it really hot where you are?
Not today. Today we have bad weather today, so rain's cooling things off. But it's been warm. It's Florida. This is Florida. It's hot here all the time. As Stephen says, summer ends in September for everybody, and then for us it's till Christmas.
Ugh.
Yeah.
Is your hair really frizzy?
No, not me.
That would just be me.
That's you. That's you. We're showing you. We're showing your image, and of course you have curly hair. And
yeah. I do.
Yeah, don't fight it. Just let the humidity do its thing.
You have to. You do. You're like, I get to a point. I've gotten to a point in my ripe middle age where I just let it do its thing. It's just senseless to try to spend any time taming it. But CBD. Hemp-derived cannabidiol, I have been using in my practice for about a year now. And I have found it to be an incredible, reliable, fast-acting adjunct to many of the therapies that I already used for things like, particularly in my practice, which is very much a perimenopause, menopausal-based hormone-balancing kind of practice. You know, I've been using it a lot for sleep, for anxiety, for stress resilience, and a host of other things, too. But for me, I'm really not overstating it when I say that it has transformed my practice in those areas in very short time. I mean, it's been one of the more amazing things I've seen in the 15 years that I've been in practice.
What's amazing is that it's trending, and so I've gone to different websites. I won't mention the names because I don't want to – it'll sound like I'm criticizing them.
Sure, sure.
And I wanted to search their site for medical news, and I type in CBD oil, zero hits.
Wow.
No, you know zero? Zero. Zero hits on some of these medical news websites that I use in my reporting. I mean, I find that astonishing, given the way this is trending. Maybe it's not trending as much as I think it is. I don't know.
Well, it depends what, you know, quote unquote space you're in as to where it's trending, right? I mean, what's interesting in regards to what you're saying is that if you go to PubMed.com, which for your listeners who may not be familiar, PubMed.com is a place where anybody can go and access peer-reviewed medical articles, research articles, and a peer-reviewed medical journal is considered the gold standard when you're looking for medical information. Obviously, there's lots of places to get information. This is considered to be a very trusted site for the medical community. If you go there and you search cannabidiol, you'll come up with, I think last week it was around 1,600 articles.
I refer the listener, It's PubMed.gov, by the way.
Right.
PubMed.gov. Yes, I was just talking about that yesterday or the day before. I was trying to educate the listener and the viewer about that website, and it's a good research website. I'm there all the time myself, but
sure.
I use other sources as well.
Of course.
And a couple of these sources that are about medical news, I typed in CBD oil, and zero hits. I thought,
sure.
Wow, I'm surprised.
Yeah, it's interesting. And I think that a lot of the information that you do find in the medical space is still more related to cannabis in general as a very broad term. And I think part of the problem is that we have a big job ahead of us in regards to educating people about what all these words mean, right? There's a lot of semantics. There's cannabis and medical cannabis and marijuana, medical marijuana, recreational marijuana. Now we have hemp oil and CBD and THC, and I think your average doctor, let alone your average consumer, it just all starts to swim and we just call it pot, and nobody really understands what the difference is between all those terms.
It's not pot, that's for sure. It's not, which is an interesting expression, term.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that at all. And that's been one of the problems in trying to educate the consumer, is to separate out CBD oil from the marijuana plant. We're talking about CBD oil derived from hemp. Of course, they both come from the same plant.
Very confusing.
It is very confusing, and people get they're mixed up. I mean, I talk to professionals, and they don't have it squared away either in their own head, in their vocabulary and how they talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
So this has been a problem in educating people. We're trying to do that on PubMed PubMed.gov right now. That's for those of you listening and watching, that's the U.S. National Library of Medicine, National Institutes of Health resource. And researchers use it all the time. And I just went in there and I typed CBD oil. Hold on. I typed in review and I only got 29 hits on CBD oil. If you just type
How about cannabidiol?
If you just type in CBD, 5,015.
Haha. Yeah.
5,015 hits talking about cannabidiol in one form or another, one fashion or another, for one reason or another. So it's trending, but it's still confusion. People don't understand its application in everyday life. Maybe Dr. Shunney can help with that and elucidate and expand upon how she's using it in her practice. I always like having guests such as Dr. Shunney on because they're in the clinical trench every day, dealing with real health issues, real people all day long. And she's got to find out what works, what doesn't work, and what is safe. So when we come back, we'll have her expand upon and elucidate further her use of it in her practice and see if it has some application for you in your life. You are listening to Let's Talk Nutrition. We are coast to coast. We're out there on the left coast where Dr. Shunney is too, including Hawaii. We're glad you're there today. We'll be right back.
Statements made during this broadcast regarding products or the claims made about specific products have not been evaluated by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. Products and treatments discussed are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent disease. Make your physician aware of all nutritional supplements used and immediately notify your physician if you have any health concern or undiagnosed sign or symptom.
Let's Talk Nutrition is a health talk show that features scientists, authors, nutrition specialists, personal trainers, holistic healers, and experts in traditional, natural, and integrative medicine. Listen for a chance to win daily prizes and follow Let's Talk Nutrition on Facebook and Instagram at Let's Talk Nutrition or on Twitter at LTN Radio. It's time for some inspiration. Tune in to get fit and healthy. It's time to talk about nutrition. Nutrition for your body, your mind, your spirit. It's time to talk about proper exercise, stress relief, eating well, and supplementation to help. Get ready to take charge of your health because your health is your wealth and the wealth of those who care about and love you. It's time for Let's Talk Nutrition with Dr. Michael Garko. Welcome to the show.
Welcome to Let's Talk Nutrition. If you just tuned in, thanks for tuning in. If you stayed over from the first portion of the show, thanks a lot for doing that. Appreciate it very much. If you listen to that introduction, I wrote that introduction 11 years ago. It's been modified a little bit, but the essential themes haven't changed. When you listen to that intro, that one sentence, take charge of your health. And, you know, in a word, that really that's what the show is trying to do. To educate you, myself, even the guests, even though they're experts, everybody has room for improvement, including me. I'll be in the first desk on that line. And it's about taking charge of your health. I'm sure that Dr. Shunney, who's my guest today in her practice, that's what she's trying to do with her patients. She's trying to empower them. She's not just trying to cure them, but she's trying to educate them, empower them to be in charge of their health. That old medical model where the doctor was in charge, meaning that, you know, the patient did and said whatever the doctor said, that's fine, but that doesn't help the doctor. It makes it harder for the doctor to practice medicine. The doctor would appreciate, she would appreciate it if the patient were more in charge and take responsibility to learn and to know more about what's going on with their body and their mind. It makes it easier for the physician, I suspect. And so taking charge of your health, that's what we're trying to do on the show. That is the essential mission of the show. Somebody said to me, and I've been interviewed numerous times, and what's your show about? And now when I'm going to be asked that question, what is Let's Talk Nutrition about? It's about educating people how to take charge of their health. Now, when you start to unpack that, there's a lot of luggage with that. Believe me, there are a lot of bags to unpack with that. We could spend this hour and the next hour and the rest of the week talking about what that means. And I wish I could say to you that it's easy. Because it's not. It's not. But it's not impossible. And maybe I should speak in more relative terms. It's a heck of a lot easier doing that than being sick and trying to get better. That's really hard. You know, so like taking charge of your health means practicing prevention, practicing preparation. Well, what do I mean by preparation? Preparing yourself for the later sectors of the life cycle, of your lifespan, where you're trying to prepare by building up enough inventory of health, let's be candid, to get you up to a place where when you start to get sick and things start to fail and you start to have system failure or systems failure, that you have enough inventory of health to make it not so difficult. So taking charge of your health is prevention, preparation, consistency, day in, day out, the humdrum of trying just to, to do the same good things over and over again. And to have the discipline to do it. It's these words roll off my tongue, but it's not so easy to do. Even physicians have a hard time doing it. And they know why they should do it. They went to school to know why they should do it, right? And in my own training, I know why, but you sometimes forget, and other things get in the way of that project, and it's an ongoing project. And I know that many people that listen and watch this show are very diligent and do better than I do, even for sure, which wouldn't take that much. I do okay. I have a lot of room for improvement. But I understand how difficult it is. So what we're trying to do on the show is, it's not enough. When I first started, I thought, well, if you dispense the information, that'll get it. No, doesn't get it done. It's not enough. We have more information. We live in an information age. We have more information than we have sense. It hasn't stopped the obesity epidemic. It hasn't knocked out coronary heart disease as the leading cause of death. Most of the chronic diseases are lifestyle. They're called diet and lifestyle types of diseases. There are some genetically induced diseases, of course. I understand that. So we have more. We have a lot of information. It's now putting the information into practice. That's where the challenge is. And that's where a good physician can help, or, you know, maybe hopefully this show will help to show you how to do it. Dr. Shunney, welcome back to Let's Talk Nutrition. I didn't mean to give your practice its mission, but I wasn't implying that that's what you're trying to do every day. But I think that's what that would be one of the things you want to do with your patients, is to teach them how to take charge of their health.
Absolutely. I mean, and get people involved in the process. I mean, you know, the benefit that I have, right, is as a naturopathic physician, as a doctor who integrates both, you know, Western modern medical science with traditional therapies and natural therapeutics, I've got a self-selected population. When they choose to come see me, I've got people who are already a bit more inspired and a bit more engaged, you know, than your average brown bear, probably similarly to the people who are choosing to listen to the show right now. And so for me, I mean, a big thing of what I talk about with my patients is that we are partnering for their health. I'm not in there to boss them, to cut them off, to tell them what we're going to talk about or not talk about. And don't get me wrong, I do often have to help people focus. There's a lot going on. But, you know, point being, you know, one of the things I ask people at their first visit is, tell me about your journey that brought you here to this moment of you being in my office, seeking out somebody like me. What are your concerns? What are your dreams? What are your goals? Let's talk about those things and let's make a plan, you know, an individualized plan to get you there, because everybody's going to get there a little differently. And the patient has to play a role in that if it's going to be successful.
But, you know, it does take a conscious effort. It takes a conscious effort and some guidance. You know, let me be candid here. You went to naturopathic school, medical school. I'm being trained in nutrition and taking courses and still doing that. You know, lots of training. I've even learned about things that you learned in medical school. So, you know, I've educated myself. And I'm still continuing to do that. It takes an extraordinary effort to do that. But even with all of that, I still find it difficult to do. As much as I know, as much as you know, I'm sure you're challenged every day, day in and out, just to try to take care of yourself. So just imagine, you have an average person, you know, they're going to work, they're trying to raise a family. They don't do this for a living. It's hard. Everything's in the, I said this the other day on the show, what I figured out here, what I think is going on, why, see, Why can't people see this? Why don't they understand? Because it's all in the abstract for them, Dr. Shunney. It's an abstraction. It's, you know, they get up in the morning, put their feet on the floor. They're just trying to get, they're trying to get through their life and get through their job and do their thing. They're not focused on this day in and day out like you and I are. It's hard to get people into that place to do it, I think. I don't know. I'm just saying. I'd be interested in what you think when we come back. You are listening to Let's Talk Nutrition. We're going to talk about CBD oil. And this is all by way of saying, I look for any way possible for you to take charge of your health that's legitimate, scientifically based, being currently used by physicians such as Dr. Shunney. CBD oil seems to show a lot of promise in this arena. We'll clarify and tell you how and in what ways.
As a family-owned company since 1968, Now Foods has spent the last 46 years building a legacy in the natural health industry as a trusted leader. Now provides a comprehensive approach to wellness by offering more than 1,400 high-quality health foods, supplements, sports nutrition, and personal care products at an affordable price. Now believes that natural is better. They don't use artificial colors, flavors, or sweeteners, and they offer many vegetarian, organic, and gluten-free products. Their foods are all non-GMO. Since their beginning, Now has grown to become an award-winning leader in the natural health industry. But one thing has never changed: their commitment to providing the highest quality products at the best value to empower people to lead healthier lives. High quality doesn't have to mean high price. From essential oils to amino acids, multivitamins to natural sweeteners, Now has you covered. To find a store near you that carries Now products, or for more information, visit nowfoods.com. That's nowfoods.com.
Are you suffering from those awful allergies? Hay fever, sneezing, watery eyes? Here's some advice you won't want to miss.
I'm a doctor, and my patients used to dread allergy season. But then I discovered A. Vogel Allergy Relief, a unique combination of natural ingredients that usually addresses every one of my patients' symptoms. And while it's clear that the vast majority of my patients benefit significantly from A. Vogel Allergy Relief, what's even more amazing is that after using it, at least half of my patients' symptoms didn't return. As a doctor, that's the kind of outcome my patients and I can appreciate.
Get doctor-recommended A. Vogel Allergy Relief for your allergy symptoms. It's proven safe, it doesn't make you drowsy, it's fast-acting, and it may even help prevent your allergies from returning. Available at Vitamin Discount Centers, Richards, Rollin' Oats, Vitamin Shop, Nutrition Smart, and other fine health food stores.
When you're passionate about your health, that passion leads to the knowledge that exercise and a healthy diet are not always enough. Sometimes you need the extra nutritional boost that only supplements can provide. If you are looking for the leading national brands of vitamins, supplements, health and beauty, weight loss, or sports nutrition products, look no further than Vitamin Discount Center. Voted Best Independent Chain by Vitamin Retailer Magazine, Vitamin Discount Center has been a trusted and valuable nutrition resource to the Tampa Bay area for over 15 years. With daily savings up to 50%, Vitamin Discount Center offers the best prices on the highest quality nutritional supplements. Not only will you find unbeatable value, your visit includes access to a staff educated on the application of products to help equip you with the products and information you need to proactively improve your health. To locate the store nearest you, visit vitamindiscountcenter.com, as well as access to articles on popular health topics, promotions, events, and thousands of products to shop from right at home. Your search for an affordable solution to better health is finally over. Vitamin Discount Center. For life, for less.
Still looking for your fountain of youth? It's Zinnia. Look no further than the beauty aisle of your favorite health and nutrition store. Zinnia is the newest product from Form Essentials, the brand that brought you Solace. So you know it's filled with the highest quality ingredients. Many cosmetic products only treat topically, while Zinnia addresses aging and hair loss from within. Formulated to support the growth of radiant hair, skin, and nails, Zinnia is sure to help you turn back the hands of time and assist you in aging gracefully. Zinnia provides a spectrum of key vitamins and other evidence-based natural ingredients such as alpha lipoic acid, biotin, and collagen and elastin peptides, all combined in one capsule for your convenience. By promoting beauty from the inside out, you're strengthening your cells and creating a lasting enhancement to your natural beauty. Zinnia fits into your daily routine and can be taken to boost your current cosmetic products. Available now at leading health and nutrition stores. Ask for Zinnia by name. Start taking Zinnia hair, skin, and nails today and get ready to look amazing. Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by VSN, Finish First, Nordic Naturals, pure and great tasting omega oils, Jaro Formulas, superior nutrition and formulation, Natural Factors, where great health begins, Kyolic, aging makes the finest garlic truly odorless, A. Vogel, Europe's leading brand of herbal medicine. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Welcome back to Let's Talk Nutrition. Dr. Aimee Shunney is my guest. We've been talking about CBD oil, and Dr. Shunney has introduced it into her practice. So, Dr. Shunney, within the context of people taking charge of their health, how can CBD, for the listeners and the viewers of the show, contribute to that goal? And perhaps you can explain or describe how they might be able to use it.
Absolutely. I think it actually fits. You made a beautiful segue for me. Thank you.
My pleasure.
I do want to say briefly, if I can just walk backwards for a moment, that I think it's important that the listeners understand exactly what CBD is. We were talking about all the confusion around words and cannabis and marijuana and CBD. And is it okay if I go back to that real quick?
No, absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay. So we were talking about how the thing that really is the most confusing thing is that medical cannabis and agricultural hemp come from the same plant, which is called cannabis sativa, right? They're cousins, basically. I mean, if you were to look at the two different plants, they look differently. And what's in them and the percentages of different constituents in each plant is quite different. And the most important difference, for the sake of this conversation, is the presence of THC, delta-9 tetrahydrocannabinol in particular. THC is one of actually over 120 different cannabinoids in the cannabis plant, but it is the one that we know the most about in regards to it is the psychoactive one. There are other minor cannabinoids that can have psychoactive effect, but THC is the one that we know about. It's the one that gets people high. It's the one that makes people feel altered, and it is the THC content that people are interested in when they're looking to use cannabis recreationally. We've also learned that there are important medical uses for THC, particularly in the realm of cancer care and helping people with pain and appetite loss and wasting and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
So the big difference between medical cannabis and agricultural hemp in regards to this conversation is the content of THC, right? If you have something that's called hemp oil or agricultural hemp, and by the way, we get our hemp protein powder and our hemp body care products and fabric and, you know, fiber, all these things from agricultural hemp. In order to be legally called agricultural hemp, there must be less than 0.3% THC in the product, in the plant material at harvest. Less than 0.3% THC, which is not enough to have a psychoactive effect.
It's almost non-existent. I mean, 0.3%. I mean, I could spit and have more than that. Come on, there's not much there. I mean,
good for you,
right? I mean, 0.3%. So you're not going to have any sort of psychoactive experience.
Correct. Now, CBD, cannabidiol, is another one of those over 120 different cannabinoids in the cannabis plant, and CBD is the same whether it comes from medical cannabis, recreational cannabis, or agricultural hemp. And what we're learning, like, you know, when you went on and saw 5,000 hits on PubMed on cannabidiol, is that it has a lot of really important potential health benefits as well, which I will talk about in a moment. When you choose to use CBD from an agricultural hemp product, so we keep talking about hemp oil or hemp-derived CBD, what you get is a standardized amount of CBD per dose, knowing all along that you are going to have less than 0.3% THC, so you don't have to worry about psychoactive effect. And this is why it has been, you know, evolutionary in my practice, is because I can help people get the amazing benefits of this plant, which we've known have been being used medicinally for over 5,000 years.
Absolutely.
Without the psychoactive effect that is, that, you know, is impairing and has stigma around it as well for a lot of people. So that, I hope, makes it a little clearer for people about what the difference is between hemp-derived CBD and, you know, going to a dispensary, let's say, if that's legal where you are, or getting a prescription from your doctor, if that's legal where you are, to go use medical cannabis, which is going to have much higher amounts of THC in it and have psychoactive effects as well.
Cannabis sativa, as you pointed out, it's a herbaceous plant in the cannabis genus, all right? And people have been, as you point out, they've been cultivating cannabis sativa since recorded history.
Yeah.
All right? And it's as a source of industrial fiber, seed oil, food, religious and spiritual practices, for heaven's medicine, and so on. Now, you have the explain to the listener and the viewer, you have the marijuana plant, and then you have the hemp plant.
Right.
The hemp has been bred now. They've almost bred out all of the THC out of the hemp, right?
Yeah. So in order to be called hemp, it has to have that very low amount of THC at the time of harvest, at dry weight.
If it violated that rule, then it would be a marijuana plant.
Yeah, it would be considered medical cannabis, and it would not be allowed to enter into, you know, into commerce in the way that, right, we have a Federal Controlled Substances Act on cannabis, which, you know, is another discussion for another day. But agricultural hemp is specifically excluded from that act because it enters into commerce as food, as fabric, is because it must have that low THC content, and therefore it is safe for consumption by the general population.
One of the carryovers of the confusion is that farmers cannot grow and harvest hemp in the United States except for university research purposes. But we can import it from other countries, hemp. We can. It makes no sense.
Looking for the perfect complement to your beauty regimen? Try Form Essentials Zinnia. The finest of its kind, Zinnia offers twice as much biotin as other formulas, which has proven to unlock the vibrancy in even the dullest of hair, skin, and nails. Zinnia breaks through and rejuvenates cells internally, helping you achieve the allure of effortless beauty. Reviving your hair, skin, and nails has never been easier. This essential blend of biotin, alpha-lipoic, and hyaluronic acid, collagen, and vitamin C creates lasting enhancements to your natural good looks. Don't go on wondering. You're worth the results. This combination of ingredients can only be found in Zinnia. Pamper yourself with a proven bit of affordable luxury and start looking your best. Ask for Zinnia by name at your nearest vitamin retailer to begin your journey to restored nails, head-turning hair, and radiant skin today. For more information, visit formessentials.com.
When your alarm goes off, do you jump out of bed with excitement? Or does it take multiple alarms, a few snooze buttons, or a morning caffeine fix to get you going? These habits and daily stress cause a vicious cycle in which sleep becomes increasingly elusive. In fact, 54% of Americans report struggles to fall or stay asleep. For a better night's rest, look no further than Solace, an all-natural dietary supplement that supports healthy sleep and relaxation so you get the rest you need to wake up clear-eyed, alert, and ready for the day. Solace has given thousands a better night's rest and the power to take back their mornings while enjoying the day ahead of them. Solace is formulated with non-addictive, scientifically proven, all-natural ingredients that support sleep and relaxation, such as melatonin, tryptophan, and 5-HTP. For more information or to order Solace, visit TakeSolace.com. Solace, for healthy sleep, naturally.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by AlgaLife, algae for life. CV Sciences, from seed to shelf. New Chapter, the benefit of nature's wisdom. Yerba Prima, pioneers in internal cleansing. Form Essentials, makers of the sleep aid Solace. Now introducing Zinnia for healthy hair, skin, and nails. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Well, there is a product supplement that's trending these days. It's CBD oil. CV Sciences is on the forefront of that. They're so good. They got the raw material. They got the excellent raw material. They're controlling it from soil to shelf. They got it in health stores throughout the country now. And what's interesting, it's trending. But when I started to do some research on it, I went to some of the regular sites that I use to see the medical news that's trending in the business. I type in CBD or CBD oil, I get nothing. They're not even dialed in yet. So this is very cutting edge, relatively new on the consumer marketing curve, consumer education curve. So we're trying to play, the show is trying to do its part to educate you about CBD. So we had a listener who's been waiting patiently, David in St. Petersburg. David, welcome to the show. I apologize for making you wait like that, but we got you on now.
Yes, a couple of weeks ago, I think it was CBD about how it made the biggest impact on those little worms they test longevity things on and building brain cells. Is that the same thing?
No, I was reporting on C. elegans and how they were using the C. elegans and aging research and extending the life of the C. elegans using different compounds. I don't think it was CDB at that time that they were using.
I think you said hemp.
Did I say hemp? Let me see. Let me type
in. I think it was coming from hemp and also cinnamon.
Yeah, it could have been. Let me see here. My notes. I'll have to look and see, David. I'll check, and then during the course of the show, I'll try to repeat if that's what I was reporting on. But it's interesting.
It was oregano, hemp, and rosemary and cinnamon. But they said hemp and oregano were the biggest sources of this stuff.
Good. Well. Dr. Shunney, hemp is hemp for sure. I mean, that's where you're going to find the cannabidiol, right?
Well, that's where you're going to find the cannabidiol. And you're saying C. elegans? So is that an organism?
Yeah, it's a worm. It's about the size of a comma. It's used in been used in aging research since the 1930s.
Interesting.
And what's interesting, it has the same neurotransmitters as we do. And so it's a good analog to use in experiments, and it's cheap and it works, and they've been able to extend the life of the C. elegans. It lives for a short period of time, a few weeks, couple of weeks. They've been able to get it over 100 days to live, and it ages very well. And one of the things they've learned is that calorie restriction is one of the experimental variables that has been confirmed time and again to extend life. Now, there are other compounds that they've tested with the C. elegans that also extend life. And David was bringing up, I was talking about this last week, and I quite frankly don't remember if I was tying it to cannabidiol or not. I'm going to have to check. But David, thank you for bringing that up, and I'll check and I'll see, okay?
Thanks.
And if I did, I'll repeat it again. Thank you so much. David's an ardent listener of the show, and I appreciate it.
Interesting. Well, clearly he was taking notes, but that sounds like a really important study that you were talking about.
Oh, they've done thousands of studies with that particular organism. The reason why they call it C. elegans, because the first name, C-A-E-N-O-R-A-H-A-B-D-I-T-I-S. You pronounce it.
Oh, good God.
Yeah, so that's why it's just C. elegans. It's a free-living, transparent nematode is what it is. It's about It's about 1 millimeter in length, the size of a comma on a page.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. And they have all the same neurotransmitters as us.
Yeah. Isn't that crazy? Isn't that crazy?
Wow.
Crazy.
Yes.
So that's why they use it, because there's a lot of similarities. And you, when you get into the research on anti-aging longevity, the experiments with C. elegans is all over the place. Thousands of studies with them.
Yeah. I mean, I'd be interested, too. I mean, hemp is such an interesting plant. You know, I mean, we talk a lot about these cannabinoids, right, like CBD and THC, but you know, it is so rich in essential fatty acids and flavonoids and terpenes and plant sterols and chlorophyll. And, you know, so whether or not the study you were talking about spoke about CBD, I don't know. But the idea that, you know, hemp could be one of these plants that could be so useful for us and for this type of organism, you know, if you think about what's actually in it, the over 500 different things that are in the plant, it's kind of no wonder that it would be helpful.
So for the people listening to the show and watching it, how might they use this supplement from CV Sciences, the CBD oil, in everyday life for what reasons?
Sure. So check it out. This is when you were talking about, you know, what are the things that we can do on a day-to-day basis to support health and longevity? I mean, the bazillion-dollar question, right? One of the things that comes to mind for me, both personally and professionally, is managing the stress in our lives better. Right? So here's the thing about cannabidiol and cannabinoids that everybody needs to understand, and that is that we have cannabinoid receptors in every major organ system of our body. Let me say that again. We have cannabinoid receptors in every major organ system of our body, and that's because we make endocannabinoids. We make our own cannabinoid-like chemicals in our bodies, right? This endocannabinoid system was only discovered in the 1980s, so it's relatively new. You know, this part of understanding why we've had cannabis as our friend for so many thousands of years, it's because, in a sense, we're almost wired to be able to get positive, you know, potentially negative, but also potentially very positive impacts from these substances. So not only do we have endocannabinoids we make ourselves, we have these phytocannabinoids from plants like cannabis and hemp in particular for this discussion, and also, as we're going to see more and more coming down the pike, pharma cannabinoids, right? So we have these cannabinoid receptors everywhere, and they are most densely distributed in the parts of the brain and nervous system that help us perceive and then respond to stress.
Mm-hmm. So how does it, like, if does it help with sleep issues? Can people take it for sleep?
Exactly,
can they take it for anxiety management? Can they take it to help them with weight loss? Can they take it to help them with just trying to have a better sense of well-being? Think about that, and when we come back, you can talk about that in the final segment. Talking with Dr. Aimee Shunney. Dr. Shunney is a practicing naturopathic physician and is an educator. Are you on the medical board for CV Sciences?
I am, yes.
She's on a medical, as she just said, medical board for CV Sciences. And CV Sciences, they control that product. They grow it. They have their own raw material, and they manufacture it. They put it in the bottle. They get it to the store. So they got in control from soil to shelf. That's what you want. Quality product. CV Sciences, CBD oil. I'll have the LTN health question for you when we come back.
Did you know that the most common form of calcium supplement today is calcium carbonate, also known as limestone? You don't eat rocks as part of your balanced diet, so why would you choose to supplement your bone health nutritional needs with limestone? Our bodies understand and seek whole food sources of nutrition. New Chapter is proud to deliver Bone Strength Take Care, a calcium complex that delivers key bone health nutrients in the form of whole food, not rocks. Bone Strength Take Care also delivers key bone nourishing nutrients, including vitamins D3 and K2. Vitamin K2 is of critical importance as it ensures calcium is placed in the bone where it's needed and stays out of the arteries where it's not. Discover for yourself the whole food bone health alternative to rocks. Bone Strength Take Care, the best-selling natural bone health supplement in America. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
The ever-increasing stress and toxicity we are exposed to from our environment, diets, and lifestyles make internal cleansing a necessary part of a good health regimen. Founded in 1980, Yerba Prima was the first company to launch a whole-body internal cleansing kit.
Since that time, they have continued to develop and manufacture a complete range of all-natural, high-quality fiber and internal cleansing products. By using all-natural psyllium fiber and no harmful stimulant laxatives, all Yerba Prima fiber and internal cleansing products can be used over a long period of time to ensure optimal health and regularity. With nearly 30 years dedicated to all-natural cleansing products, it's easy to see why Yerba Prima is a leader in the fiber and cleansing products category. Learn more at yerbaprima.com, YERBAPRIMA.com, or visit your local health retailer. Yerba Prima, pioneer in internal cleansing products.
Feel tired, lethargic, or irritable? Take Solace. You're one of millions of Americans that has trouble falling asleep or staying asleep. In fact, according to a national survey, 54% of adults have trouble sleeping. So what can you do about it? Take Solace. Solace is an all-natural dietary supplement formulated to support healthy sleep and relaxation. Solace can help you fall asleep and stay asleep naturally. Formulated with all-natural ingredients, Solace is non-addictive and won't leave you feeling groggy in the morning. Take Solace an hour before bed and feel the calming effects of this extensively researched sleep and relaxation aid. For more information on Solace, call toll-free 877-533-7066 or visit TakeSolace.com. That's 877-533-7066 or TakeSolace.com. Look for Solace in your local health and nutrition store. Solace, for a good night's rest naturally.
The latest trend to hit the store shelves has the whole country buzzing. Cannabidiol, or CBD, might just be the greatest discovery of our generation, and it comes from a plant that is not so new, agricultural hemp. Yes, after 70 years of prohibition and misunderstanding, hemp is back to help you stay healthy and balanced. Growing research is showing that we have a lot to learn from the remarkable hemp plant. Nutrient-rich products like Plus CBD Oil's Total Plant Complex concentrated products provide broad-spectrum nutrition, including fatty acids, plant sterols, cannabinoids, terpenes, and naturally occurring vitamin E. From seed to shelf, all Plus CBD Oil products provide the highest quality hemp-derived CBD products available and are offered in a variety of delivery systems and flavors to suit your needs. Ask your local independent health food store about Plus CBD Oil products by CV Sciences today and learn more about the CBD evolution at PlusCBDOil.com. That's PlusCBDOil.com.
Feeling tired after your meal? Occasional gas, bloating, or indigestion at inopportune times? You may have an enzyme deficiency. Did you know that many common digestive discomforts can be caused by poor digestion? When food isn't completely digested, it begins to ferment in the digestive tract, which may cause uncomfortable symptoms. Digest Gold, America's number one selling enzyme product, offers unparalleled support for your digestive needs. It contains exclusive blends of enzymes optimized to be 3 times stronger and work more than 6 times faster than other leading digestive supplements. With just 1 capsule per meal, Digest Gold offers support to break down carbohydrates, fats, fiber, and protein. Enzymedica products are all natural, vegetarian, contain absolutely no fillers, and are vegan and kosher when possible. You'll find Digest Gold and other Enzymedica products at fine health food stores near you. These statements have not been evaluated by the Food and Drug Administration. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease.
Let's Talk Nutrition is brought to you by Now Foods, Our Products Work, American Biotech Labs, your daily immune system support, Renew Life, the digestive care company, Country Life, a leader and authority in natural health and nutrition, Enzymedica, the enzyme experts, North American Urban Spice, the only oregano oil you can take on a daily basis. Let's Talk Nutrition on the web at letstalknutrition.com. We're back from the break, so let's rejoin Dr. Michael Garko.
Here's the LTN health question of the day. Earlier in the show, I was reporting on the Zika virus, and I was trying to share with you, my goal was to share with you the origins of the virus and how it got connected to mosquitoes and then infecting humans. And in my reporting, I shared with you that the Zika virus was first detected in a place in Uganda called the Zika Forest, okay, and they found it in a rhesus monkey. And then I went on and I told you that up until about 2007, there were very few cases of Zika in humans that were being reported. Then there was an outbreak in Micronesia, of all places, at a place called Yap Island, Y-A-P. And unfortunately for the people and the inhabitants of that island, 75% of the population got infected with the Zika virus. So you can just imagine the microencephaly among the population. I'll have to look into that. But here's the question. In what year was the Zika virus first detected in Zika forest in Uganda, in that rhesus monkey? Was it 1947, 1957, or 1967? In what year did they first detect the Zika virus in the Zika forest in Uganda? 1947, 1957, or 1967? 877-897-8255. Phone lines, boom, lit up. In response to David, I was trying to find my reporting on that anti-aging study. I can't get my hands on it. Where they used the Cenorhabditis elegans. That's why they call it C. elegans, because if I had to say Cenorhabditis elegans every time, I'd run out of air. So that's just C. elegans. And I can't find the story. Don't recall it being connected to cannabidiol. I just don't have the time to find it. I report on scores of studies every week, if not hundreds, that I look at just to get a few on the air. So I sometimes will lose it, literally. Dr. Shunney, welcome back.
Thank you.
I lose the study and I lose myself. So in everyday life, then, you see a great practicality for the use of CBD oil, helping with sleep. And does it help mood and temperament?
Well, yeah. I mean, if you think about it, if you go back, I mean, the reason I went back to that biochemistry about the CBD receptors and their ability to help us perceive and respond to stress in a more grounded, resilient way, you think about clinically how that trickles down for people. And, you know, so the biggest thing for me is I see people getting more restful, recuperative sleep. And that's whether they've got an acute sleep issue or they've got, you know, this has helped people with intractable sleep issues for decades. And let's face it, once you are sleeping better, mood is better, energy is better, libido is better, your ability to get your butt to the gym and cook a proper meal is better, you know, metabolic function is better. I mean, all of these things cascade down from sleep. But even for people who are already sleeping well, I see it helping a lot with mood stability and anxiety. You know, and for me, again, you know, those are very, very common issues that I see multiple times every single day in my practice. I also absolutely use it for pain and inflammation, chronic fatigue, fibromyalgia.
How has it worked with pain and inflammation with chronic fatigue and fibromyalgia? How's that working?
Well, you know, we don't know exactly how it's working, but we do know.
In terms of effect.
Yeah. Oh, well, it's anti-inflammatory. So anytime there's pain and inflammation, I mean, it's going to be reducing inflammation itself as a, you know, it's helping to reduce those inflammatory cytokines that create that sensation, I'm tripping over my words here. Actually preventing the inflammatory process and modulating the inflammatory process. Mm-hmm. It's also impacting, though, how we perceive pain, right? There's a big emotional component to pain that involves fear around pain, and that makes pain worse. And it's thought that this is one of the ways in which it helps with that. It also has immune modulating effects. So, you know, it's potentially useful when we have dysregulation of the immune system, as with autoimmune conditions and cancer. So we're still trying to elucidate all the exact mechanisms of action, but because those CBD receptors are in every organ system of the body, it's no surprise that we see effects throughout every organ system of the body.
Excellent. Let's go to Venice, Florida. Stuart, welcome to the show. In what year, what was the year when they first detected that Zika virus in the rhesus monkey in the Zika forest in Uganda? Was it 1947, 57, or 67, Stuart?
47.
1947. Yeah, congratulations. How did you know that?
Well, I was listening, and you know, it was before I was born. So I was born in 49, so it stuck with me that how long it's been around.
It's been around quite a while. So it's in Miami. I don't know if it's going to make its way into other parts of Florida or throughout Miami. I have no clue, but I'll keep my eye on it too, and I'm sure it'll be in the news, Stuart.
Yeah, it's a big deal. Well, you're down here. You know, it's a big deal in the news every day.
No question about it. Those people in Miami, I'm sure, are pretty nervous. Thank you for listening, Stuart, and thank you for calling in.
Thank you, regular listener.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Carolyn, you had a question about drug testing.
Yes, I take the CBD oil myself, and I'm a big fan. And I have a friend who would also like to take it, but she works in a job that requires frequent drug testing.
Good question.
She's afraid that she could get a positive reading.
Well, let's see. Let me ask Dr. Shunney. Dr. Shunney, we're almost out of time. Is that a concern?
Yes. There is a trace amount of THC. We've done a lot over at CV Sciences. They've done a lot of testing to try to find, how likely it is that there'll be a positive test. And, you know, the vast majority of the testing they've done with the doses that we generally recommend do not show up positive, but you simply can't guarantee it. So if somebody is relying on passing a drug test, unfortunately at this time, this isn't something you should take. And by the way, they also shouldn't be protein powder, eating poppy seeds, taking cough medicine, etc.
There you go. See? That's why it's nice to have a doctor. Carolyn, that was a good question. Thank you so much.
Good question.
Thank you very much, Carolyn.
Thank you for the product. I have very good results with it. I don't seem to gain weight, and I have a feeling of well-being when I take it, so I'm a big
fan. Wonderful. I'm glad you found it.
Excellent indeed. CV Sciences, Carolyn, thank you. Dr. Shunney, thank you. Everybody else, each and every one of you, thank you. I don't like to talk about, you all. I like to talk to you. Thank you for listening to the show. Your health is your wealth, and your health is the wealth of those that care about and love you.